Good morning, everyone. Agatavach, Shavua Tov. We are continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. And we are on Hilchas Niske Gufay, the laws of bodily damages. And today's halacha will somewhat round off this section of the halacha. And tomorrow, Be'ez Hashem, we're going to go into another idea that revolves around Niske Mama, but a little bit different than direct damages, what we are discussing. Hachayva Bechaveray, somebody who injures his friend. Again, whether he did it intentionally or unintentionally. Injuring means that he gave him a good patch, he gave him a punch, he gave him a zetz, as they say in Yiddish, and he caused him some kind of bruise or cut or broken bone or the like. Even though that he pays him for his injury, which is the obligation that he has to pay him for the damage that he caused. So if you broke his arm and you pay for all the doctor's bills, v'chein ganav oy gazlan, so too if somebody stole from somebody, ava b'sheich ziras shilma, and then or shilma, or he returns the lost object, the stolen object, or he pays him, he used the stolen object already and now he has to pay him back, so he restored the value that was lost. So either you have repaid the person back for the injury or you restored the value of the stolen object. Nevertheless, don't think that you finished over here and that you have been atoned for your transgression. Until you go and you ask mechila, you ask forgiveness from the person that you punched and you hit or you broke his bone. Or the person that you robbed and you took their money, or the person who you stole money from. Alatzar shahayulahem. You have to go and ask them forgiveness for the tsar, for the anguish that they experienced, which means even though that you took care of the monetary loss over here, you restored it by returning the stolen object, or you paid them the money for the stolen object. If you hurt somebody, you broke a bone on them, and you paid all the doctor's bills, you paid them for all that. Nevertheless, there is pain and humiliation that a person will go through. Tsar and baishas, there's pain and humiliation that a person is going to go through, and that is not compensated by money. And therefore, if you want to be forgiven for that, says the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, you must go and ask that person for forgiveness. I'm sorry that I punched you. I'm sorry that I broke your bone. I'm sorry that I did this. Can you please forgive me? I paid you back the money now to take care of all your doctor's bills. Please forgive me for the pain and the embarrassment that I might have caused you. Says the Gemara, Vehem, and those who experience the anguish over here, when they are asked over here that they should be forgiven, Vehem Yimchalu, they should in fact give forgiveness very easily and readily. Veloye Achzar, they should not be cruel and withhold the forgiveness, which means the way the Jewish people is that we forgive and we can forget. And if somebody will come to us and they will apologize for the damages that they caused us and the pain that they inflicted, the embarrassment they might have done to us, our job as a Jew is not to bear a grudge and hold on to the pain, but rather we have a mitzvah not to be achzari, not to be cruel, and we say, Meichelach, 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 I forgive you, I forgive you, I forgive you. It's out of my heart, out of sight, out of mind. You are now going to be forgiven, not only for the monetary damages, but for the spiritual, emotional pain that you caused as well. And you can go and live happily ever after right now. Okay, have a wonderful day. We'll continue Be'ez Hashem tomorrow. All the best.